So hello everyone, welcome back to BNZ. So today's episode we're gonna add Galapagos giant tortoises. So I made the huge group, so that is an exabyte. If you want some advices, I used the null, so as barriers, so nobody can tease these guys. You can enter barriers. It's like invisible barrier. If you want to build on it, so I put it like a bit of everything everywhere. So our chapters are simple. It's like this guy, that's things that have been thrown out there, and this guy is an arch. I know. Here are the Galapagos. So I put some trees and things, so it makes a bit more natural. So as you can see, I made big work without you, because it took me like half an hour or an hour. So you know, I'm gonna add more environment enrichment and things like that. The last touches with you and tell you like a bit how you do that. So let's come to nature. Okay, so what is important when while doing these things is to have like a little idea, but also to if you want to improvisate while doing the like this thing, I mean it's a habitat, however you want to do it. It's important also to like have a theme in your head, and then you throw everything everywhere so it looks like been there from 30-40 years. I really like putting in these habitats rocks, because rocks come with time, I mean. And also it's important to add some of those guys that are the, how it's called, the lian vine, the vines I prefer to call them. Why they give more nature of a place where human used to be lived, and that nature took as their domain, if you want. Yeah, as you can see on these places, I throw these kind of rocks, if you want, I don't know how to call these guys, a bit of everywhere, so we can it's like a bit of broken things, and you know, makes it kind of cool. So and that's what we want cool little things with everywhere. So there you see, it's not really coverage, these don't count as coverage, but always make sure that don't pass the null barrier. So if here's a null barrier, let's say you can see it, if I put it this only, then I added this, because this can be like an escapable point for the turtles. They can't go far, so they only can rest in there. Well, it's a bit of not, you don't want to see like 7-6 message of an animal escaped, or you don't know. Okay, strangle fig, rot edge, this can be nice. Like dead trees make the habitat, the place, if you want, older. I like to put these kind of guys in the place where it should be old, if it shouldn't be old, so it doesn't make sense to put them. So, oh my goodness, this will be a really nice thing right there. Wow, this can make a lian vine. I mean, however you want to call that, it doesn't matter, it's kind of cool. Tree. Okay, we use the tree for like completely something else, and that is something important in these habitats. Like this thing, what it is. One sec. I made something right there. I took seropia tree that I turned. It's not this good. It's not, but it gives a bit of living dead, if you want. Switch cheese. So the strangler fig will be nice fitting right there. But we see We should see. Our advantage coverage. Okay, so 37%. We can take much more. Okay, so I think they can take 50%. So tamarin trees, the yellow IP are really nice. I'm gonna show you these guys. Yes, the yellow IP tree. Which of right everywhere. And in these places, I like to put coverage. I don't know why. It's not because of a really specific thing. It's just, it's nice. You come, you see this, you see nature, jungle, and a Mayan temple if you want. So, this is a prefab thing. I won't say something out, but the rest is like kind of good. So I'm gonna better know. So it's a nice place. Okay, so you can get here from the fountain of BNZ or from right there. I was thinking about doing a high place, like I don't mean high, I mean elevated. Yeah, that's it. That is the word. Elevated roof. No, that's not the one. The rustic pass. This rustic pass is really nice. I found it. I like it. Holy god. What the hell just happened? Should be kind of bug. Not a problem. I'll fix it. Okay, so I cannot pass this because of the nail. So it's not a problem also. So you guys can have this look of a habitat. You barely can see Galapagos giant tortoises. Maybe you can put another animal right in there. I don't know. Let's come to the BNZ check. Okay, I don't know. I'm just gonna let it. This tortoise is right in there. So let's come. Okay. Don't tell me why you didn't put the Galapagos giant tortoises. It's same on the Eldabra. Okay, it's always the same toys. After all, the turtles and the other are also turtles. So yeah, the hard shot is still bad. Oh man, you guys are really needy. Okay, no, they're not needy. I give you barely what you need, but it's not a problem. It's because of you. Okay, so I was thinking, or more, I am thinking of putting this guy up there. Like, being like right there from hundreds of years, and now it's in the zoo, being used as a heart shelter. I know it's shameful, these guys who made that. But it's okay. I'm sure hundreds of persons have been killed to put that up there. But it's not a problem. Okay, so it's 100%. Yeah. Okay, nature. No, we don't need nature. We said, yeah, we're putting. Yeah, I think I put it in the food trough. Yeah, here it is. Water enrichment right there. As a reminder, in a zoo, never think about how people are gonna see this. You can imagine it's more important to do a good place for your animals, a nice place, so you can be happy of it. Why I'm telling you that, because actually there nobody can really see these guys. It's not a problem. I mean, people you can manage the path, but never think about letting the pants down and how can people see you, like right there. It is impossible to see, but you'll always find things. And this thing is like floating. Thanks, goodbye. Okay, so I think this is a nice little habitat where we can see nothing but ancient runes, Maya, and things like that that are really nice. And here are the Galapagos giant tortoise. Just like the entry, here you have the food trough area. and the yellow IP, and that is the door to come to the area where you have rocks more than anything else. So it was the first time I tried to do something like that, like I mean a Maya rune or something like that, South American rune from nothing. I usually used prefabs and joined them together. Yeah, I was a cheater, but I think it's nice. It's really good. I'm proud of it. Let's let time run a little bit. And let's see these. Okay, the temperature, I think they're too hot, but they're gonna be fine. Believe me, they're gonna be fine. Train, environment. Okay, everything's good. Seems good to me. I'm just gonna add. This habitat gate is really annoying. You can't not put a habitat gate. You should put a habitat gate, whatever are the consequences. So it's just a bit weird to have a door in the middle of nowhere. No, it's unusual. So, okay, don't be. I don't know why, but they always put animals you have in the trade center. That's what I was trying to tell you. You'll be surprised by seeing chimpanzees. I find two incredible chimpanzees. I don't know if the chimpanzees are going to be our next animals. I have no idea. So, thanks, Planet Zoo. After 3 seconds, I had three diseased animals. This should spread. This genuhid. Okay, I don't want to know what this is. He's got a thing. No, I have two different diseases. That is insane. Okay, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna just wait for the vets to come. I can hire one more because I have unlimited money. It's sandbox after all. So yeah, thank you for watching the video. I hope you liked the whole thing. Maya idea for the Galapagos giant tourist. I'm really sorry I couldn't show you how I made every piece of it. Just took me like hours to do that, so I wanted to do that. I also have records, but I just deleted them. It took me like 2-3 hours to, no, not that much, half an hour to do that. So thanks for watching the whole video. Please subscribe and like the video, and goodbye.